to Caltex's Javelin on the Limit, the motorsport show from the Asia Pacific and for the Asia Pacific. This week's program is more Asia than Pacific, as we cover the Malaysian round of the Asia Pacific Rally Championship. The weather, not unusually, is hot. And so's the contest at the front of the rally.
Three right miners of the crest, try to climb.
It's a comeback story. The fifth round of the 2000 Asia Pacific Rally Championship marks the return of Rally Malaysia to the series after a year's absence. It's also Asia Pacific points leader Possum Bourne's return to a rally he used to know well, an event he won in 94 at the height of Asian campaigns that won him two APRC titles. A rally he hasn't done in years. Finally, it's top Japanese rally driver Katsuhiko Taguchi's comeback to the championship after getting in just a few kilometres of Rally New Zealand and missing the Chinese round altogether. There are a few expected entrants who don't make the comeback, including Formula 2 points leader Simon Evans and repeat F2 champion Monster Tajima. And enough stayaways to reduce the lineup of entries that go over the start ramp in downtown Kuala Lumpur to just 14. So, quantity this rally doesn't have. But with Taguchi along to take on Bourne and local hero Karamjit Singh on hand to step in if they stumble, it does have quality up front. Bourne's the odds-on favourite, given his two-round victories already in this Asia Pacific Championship. But then he's got his third title to concentrate on, and almost within his grasp. So his aim on the track through the rubber and palm oil plantations is very clear.
Get it to the end. I think with the way the weather can change here and how rough it was in the recce, and you know, you go around one corner and it's mud and the next corner is fine, it's going to be pretty hard work. But so we won't be sticking our neck out too far, I don't think. The most important thing is the championship. Can't lose sight of that. That's what we're here for. That's what we're trying to do. And if we lose one or two on the way, I'm not too concerned about that. As long as we're collecting, we can keep collecting points.
Yeah. So if Taguchi goes for it today, I'm just going to let him.
Absolutely.
Taguchi, on the other hand, is here with just one thing in mind. His title chances have long since gone. He won't even bother competing in the Thai finale. So he's here essentially to win the rally, and he's come prepared.
We have 4 days testing, so we could run about 200, over 200 kilometers of testing. So I have confidence at the moment.
Nevertheless, the Malaysian tracks that are likely to be super slick after recent rain will demand a careful start.
Yeah, it's much caution because New Zealand we couldn't finish. So first day must finish first day. So then I will know how far difference is possible.
Both Taguchi and Bourne believe that Singh could be a factor here, especially if it's wet. Even though he's in a Group N car, giving away a lot of power to their Group A entries. Singh reckons, though, that local knowledge can actually work against you.
Yes, anything can happen, it's true. But, I mean, it also can happen to me as well. So, yeah, I mean, though it's our home event, we have more knowledge here, but still, even we get caught out sometimes, yeah.
And the number one driver for Malaysian car maker Proton won't necessarily have it all his own way either at the head of the production class. Also entered here for the team is former top circuit racer turned rally driver Jimmy Lowe at the wheel of an older Proton Wira. Italian Nico Calderola resumes his APRC campaign in an Evo 6 Mitsubishi Lancer after missing Rally China. And former Proton Works driver Saladin Maslan is launching his new rally team with a Group N Subaru Impreza and Karamjit in his sights.
Yeah, hopefully I can give him a run for his money.
The absence of Asia Pacific Formula 2 leader Simon Evans gives Malaysian Gunasilan Raju, winner of the 2-litre class in the Indonesian opening round, a chance to take the lead from the Australian hot favourite. But he'll have to dominate, win the class for each leg and for the overall rally. And unfortunately for him, there's tough competition from two more Proton Satrias in the 2-wheel drive non-turbo class. Swede Mats Andersson's never rallied outside Europe before. But his Satria is the Group A car he used to win the British title in the new Super 1600 class. Whereas both Raju and Indian champion Hari Singh are driving less powerful and less developed Group N versions. Still, the Malaysian's main aim is the new Asian Zone Challenge, which he leads. Despite his cautious talk, Bourne's fast straight out of the blocks. In hot, dry and dusty conditions, albeit with muddy puddles in places, he wins the first 9 kilometre stage by 8 seconds from Katsu Taguchi. And from Karamjit Singh. Remarkably, the Malaysian Group N driver ties for second with the Group A Rally Art Lancer. Now though, Taguchi takes over. The young Japanese driver wins the second stage by 8 seconds, tying the lead. And despite a small brake problem, he then opens an 11-second lead on the 21K SS3.
First stage, we slow down because of wet condition, very wet. Yep. So just gentle. The second stage, see the road is quite dry, so we attack a little bit. So, but quite fast.
Bourne is not quite so happy. The Subaru engine's running just a little off song, denying him full power.
It's got no power. Feels like the turbo's not working properly or something like that. We're scratching our heads now, trying to work it all out.
No.
We'll find it. Just take a little walk.
So tomorrow, some more power would be nice.
Yes. And response. It's got no power or response, so it's really difficult to get it around the corners.
Singh also suffers. After his standout stage one, he's going for it again on SS2. But now, a puncture forces him to slow. And on the next stage, he loses third and fourth gears, and a lot more time. He does hold on to third and the Group N lead, but he's now more than 3 minutes behind Taguchi and likely to lose more.
Very unlucky, I mean very unhappy as well.
Oh, yeah.
They can change the gearbox here, but I think 45 minutes is not enough for them. So we'll probably lose some, I guess some penalties or something.
Time, yeah.
Singh does pick up a 1 minute lateness penalty. But Lowe cops 50 seconds worth as well. And so he stays fourth, a standout debut in the older Proton Wira. Calderola and Saladin vie for fifth, the Italian eventually prevailing. Despite suspension damage on the rough roads, both are within 41 seconds of Karamjit's Group N lead.
Are you still glad you decided to do the Asia Pacific Championship? It's very different from home.
It's beautiful.
Okay.
It's beautiful.
Extra difficult for us. It's very difficult from the Reiki.
Yeah.
And so some parts are still very wet and some that were very wet now are dry. So
yeah.
not
yeah.
easy.
Yeah, when we wreck it, it was terrible. It was a lot of water everywhere, and it's the opposite. It's slippery because it's dry.
In Formula 2, Raju takes the honours on SS1. Only to hit a tree soon after this on stage 2, breaking the steering and becoming one of 3 retirements. That leaves things clearly in Anderson's control. The Swede building a 2-minute lead in F2 by day's end, even being careful.
Very tricky because I don't know how fast to go over the bad sections, how hard it will hit the car and turn it sideways and things like that. So it's like starting slowly and building up. So.
Yeah.
Maybe it helps that his last surviving rival, Hari Singh, is also making his debut on the tricky plantation tracks. Singh ends up 8th outright after a steady start.
We were really scared when we were doing the recce. It was really wet. Things have eased up a little bit. It's much better driving now.
Misfire or no misfire, Bourne is still on a bit of a charge to start leg 2 in fine, cooler conditions. But there's not much in it. As in, just 1 second quicker than Taguchi over the first 9-kilometre stage, a repeat of yesterday's opener. And remarkably, just 1 second faster than the Mitsui driver again in the next 22K test, a rerun of stage 2. And then 4 seconds on SS6. Bringing Taguchi's lead down to just 5 seconds. Now Taguchi comes back at him. In the 18 kilometres of Tanamera 1, he takes 10 seconds out of Bourne. Singh settled in third. An early charge brings Saladin fifth place, ahead of Calderola, now nursing clutch problems. Saladin also puts pressure on fourth place Lowe, until he stages a fight back. Anderson sixth or seventh all morning, opening his F2 lead out to more than 5 minutes on Hari Singh. Restarter Raju, intent on salvaging some Asian Zone Challenge points, is regularly second quickest in F2. Now though, on a return to yesterday's stage 3, there's an outbreak of high drama. Taguchi heads off into retirement. He's forced to park the Lancer midway through. It's engine damaged.
Yeah, it's a very bad luck.
What happened?
Actually, we broke engine mounting to the right-hand side. The engine is moved to front to touch the radiator. After maybe some few jump, engine mount going down again. So engine mount break the cam fully. So engine stopped. Yeah, after that we stopped the junction, so for some never come. But that's ready.
Bourne doesn't know his arch rival's out when he starts the stage, and he hasn't reached the stricken Mitsubishi when the power steering fails on the Subaru. Bourne and co-driver Mark Stacey have just finished some makeshift repairs when Singh goes by. Bourne has to wrestle the car out of the stage. He makes it, man and machine, hot and bothered. Then he has to do it again on the next stage as well, before he can get to service.
So
So Possum, it's turned into one of those days, one of those rallies.
Yeah, I suppose occasionally you have a bit of problems.
It's, yeah.
You know, we can't complain. It's been pretty good to us, but it's hard work to, I can't explain how difficult it is to drive with it gone. It's just like it's seized and it's at the hairpins. You've got to wrench it get it to turn in, isn't it? And if you accelerate too hard, you can't keep up with the steering and it'll just spin off the road.
After going by Bourne, Singh presses on, taking his first stage win. He beats Bourne by 3 minutes 41 seconds.
80, right hand, crest 30, fast left 7.
Andy takes another 22 seconds off the Kiwi on the next stage.
30, caution,
but for Singh's penalty for lateness during yesterday's gearbox dramas, the lead gap would be down to just 4 seconds. As it is, it's 64 seconds, provided the Subaru can be fixed during its normal service time. A big effort by Bourne's team sees the steering fixed, setting up a return to Possum Power with a win over Karamjit on SS10. And so, after all the drama, and still with a down on power engine, Bourne goes to the end of day service with a 69 second lead on Singh. Singh does have the satisfaction of winning leg 2 outright.
But anyway, we're not thinking about Possum at all, obviously, right. So we just want to maintain our lead in group, and I think it's roughly 2 minutes 56 seconds at the moment.
That's good.
Which is good. I mean, just maintain that just for home. Tomorrow. Well, even if we are ahead today, tomorrow he'll definitely make it back, you know, so not really bothered about, thinking about him at all, because we know he'll take it back tomorrow.
Remarkably, 3 others also struck trouble on stage 8. Jimmy Lowe retiring from 4th place. And restarters Raju and Mike Ariakasamy retire for the second time. When Hari Singh catches Raju limping out late in the stage, they almost add a cameraman to the casualties. Lowe's retirement sees Saladin now 3rd, 3 minutes 40 seconds behind Singh.
Now we can back off a bit because we're a bit too far from Karamjit.
Calderola's 4th, about the same distance back. F2 leader Anderson is now 5th, out of 7 survivors, 7 minutes clear of Hari Singh.
I think now it's working quite well, so still a lot of things to learn, but it's getting better.
Local Singh and Maslin pretty much sum up how it is for everyone through the final day.
Just cruising to the finish line.
Yeah, just want to finish the rally now, easing off.
The order during the day's 84 kilometres of competition is unchanged. The hardest charger on this last day is possibly Rosalie Abdullah, making up for the frustrations of retiring on day 1. But Possum Bourne's Impreza must be back at full power. Even in backed off mode, he quickly opens up his lead again. He puts 80 seconds onto the gap back to Singh in the first 2 stages, covering just 30 kilometres. And he continues the same way throughout the final day, adding another 2.5 minutes to the lead margin en route to the Kuala Lumpur finish line. He wins by 4 minutes 53 seconds. Singh too gradually builds another 90 seconds on his lead over Saladin, ending up better than 5 minutes clear. The Subaru driver is third, delighted with his rookie team's debut, a standout result in his career.
I think this is the best so far because it's all done with family and friends. So a lot of people help us out and everything, so I'm very happy, yeah.
Calderola has been backed off here, determined to make the finish and learn as much as he can as a lead up to a big APRC campaign in 2001.
I am very, very, very happy. Yeah. This rally is very, very difficult and very different the rally in Europe.
Anderson finishes fifth in his little Proton, taking F2 honours by more than 12 minutes.
Yes, top five and first Formula 2.
Yeah.
What more can you ask for? We had a bit of a struggle on the last stage because the box is bad. The gearbox broke, so we didn't dare to use third gear, and so it's making lots of bad noises.
Hari Singh takes sixth and maximum points in the Asian Zone Challenge, setting the scene for a showdown with Raju in Thailand.
No problems, all 3 days, no problems at all.
Very good.
Yeah, actually, I didn't have to push or anything. I didn't drive very hard because I didn't have much competition there because Gunnar went out, unfortunately.
Even with the Thai final round to come, Bourne wraps up the APRC driver's title. He now shares with Swede Kenneth Eriksson the honour of being the most successful driver ever in the APRC, equaling Eriksson's 3 titles.
How's it feel now?
Yeah, bloody good, you know. Just a bit of good inner satisfaction, you know. So they were saying to Stace before when we were driving down there, he hadn't won an overall championship in his 20 years of rallying, and now he wins 2 in 2 weekends. He's pretty happy, I can tell you that.
It's been a hard rally, hasn't it?
It is. It's tough. It's hot, and it's slippery, and it's rough, and it's a bit of everything, you know. Yeah. So I suppose in context, it's an all-round test of the car, you, the tyres, the package, the team, and then everybody came through today, so it's good. Anything worth having, you have to work for, don't you? And the team and everybody worked their backsides off this weekend, so team effort from everyone.
Singh's second outright in the championship. And Taguchi's bonus points for winning the first leg edge him into third. Subaru wraps up the manufacturer's title as well with this win. And Bourne's co-driver, Mark Stacey, has enough points as well to clinch the Navigator's title.
I'd won the Grip N Championship in Australia 4 times,
yeah.
But hadn't won outright in Australia, so we've won that, and now the Asia Pacific 2 titles in 2 weekends.
Good.
Yeah. I hope they have nice champagne in Malaysia. Yeah.
A good one here, eh?
It's been excellent, It's been a good. It's been a hard slog, even though there's not many, not much of a competitors left in the field, but just getting through the conditions here is the battle in itself.
Singh's dominant Group N win earns him his second APRC title. No one else even close on points.
Yes, of course, home ground and second overall, first in Group N.
Yeah.
Very happy with that, yeah. Yeah, looking forward to next year in a Group A car, yeah.
Good.
Yeah, so hopefully we might get one if we get enough sponsors, yeah.
Anderson's win sees him leapfrog Raju for second in the F2 Drivers' Cup, keeping the contest well and truly open for the finale, with Singh up to fourth as well. And in the 2-litre manufacturer's standings, Proton goes back ahead of Volkswagen.
Three right miners of the crest, take this line.
Thank you.
Next week on Caltex Javelin on the Limit, the new Asia Pacific champion burns it up in Australia with his other big title win.